Hey, scholars, how's everybody? It's Miss Margaret, and it's time for music class. I'm so glad you decided to join me today. My classical music is playing in the background. It makes me feel so happy and calm and serene. We've got a lot to do today, so we're going to get started. I'm going to play a video that I played last week, but I really like it because of the message. It's all about respect, and that's what the world needs right now, more respect. So watch the video, sing along, and I'll be back.
Personal space. Keep your hands to yourself
and please stay out of my face.
And your words. Words can hurt as strong as a fist. So use them very gently like a flick of the wrist.
You get my gist?
Mm-hmm.
Now you see how I feel. Deep in the 10 a.m. I got a name
and I'm real.
For all you bullies. Back up, back off,
and get back.
Listen to yourself before you start an attack.
Some people have a reason. They do what they do. Maybe you saw it before.
Maybe it happened to you.
Or maybe it's something in your life that you've seen. Or maybe on a TV or computer screen.
But it doesn't make it right if you know that it's wrong. You know the truth inside all along. Be strong.
It's for respect. R-S-P-E-C-T. I give it to you and you give it to me. It's for respect. R-S-P-E-C-T. You gotta treat people respectfully. It's for respect. R-S-P-E-C-T. I give it to you and you give it to me. It's for respect. R-S-P-E-C-T. You gotta treat people respectfully.
All right. R-E-S-P-E-C-T, respect. I respect you, and you respect me, and the world will be a much, much better place. So let's get to work. Last week, I talked about the treble clef and the bass clef. I even gave you an assignment and told you to draw some. You start on the bottom, go around and curl it. I even showed a video that taught you how to make a treble clef and a bass clef. And I hope you did your homework. There's the bass clef, here's the treble clef. So what we're going to do today is we're going to put these two clefs together. The treble clef sits on the treble staff, the bass clef sits on the bass staff. And when you put them together, it's called the grand staff. So I'm going to show you a short video, and we're going to talk about the grand staff today. explained a little more to you about what the grand staff is. The grand staff is when the treble clef staff, which is on top, and the bass clef staff on the bottom are brought together. And the way you bring them together is you just draw a line, and then you make this little thing here. And that's called a brace. And that brace is what makes this one staff, which is the grand staff. So this is now ready to get some music. So if I just put a little, some notes on here. It's music. And I'll put some notes here on the bottom. And that is actually music. The treble clef is, and the bass clef, and with the grand staff, you put them together. So, all it is putting that treble clef staff and the bass clef staff together with a brace, and you have the grand staff, and that's what most music is written on. So now, I hope you understand the concept of the grand staff. What I'd like for you to do for your homework is to draw one. Draw a treble clef staff, draw a bass clef staff, put a line on the sides, both sides, which puts them together. Draw a brace. This is called the brace. And then you'll have your own grand staff, and you can draw some notes. Draw some space notes, some line notes. Just draw some circles on there and write your own song. Maybe when I see you, I can play it. So I want you to do for your homework, make your own grand staff. If you don't understand, the good thing about this being a video is that you can go back and you can watch it again. Okay? All right, I'm looking forward to seeing that homework. So today for Black History, I thought we would talk about music. And the music we're going to talk about today is reggae. Reggae is music that was developed in Jamaica, in the 1960s. It was used for news, for social commentary, and for gossip, which I thought was funny. News, social commentary, and gossip. That's what the music was used and is used for, because it's very, very popular. Reggae is associated with Jamaica. Whenever you hear reggae, you think about Jamaica. So it is also associated with a religion called Rastafari. So the Rastafarians use reggae when they have their services. The heavy instruments that you hear in reggae are bass and drums. The beat of that music is based heavily on bass and drums. So when you hear that music, it's usually in 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's it playing in the background. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's the bass and the drum keeping those beats. One of the most popular reggae artist ever was Bob Marley, who's passed away now. But Bob Marley wrote hundreds of reggae songs about politics, about all kinds of things. His sons now are very popular artists now in Jamaica. So I'm going to play a video called Three Little Birds, which is one of my favorite Bob Marley songs. I hope you like it.
About a thing, 'cause every little thing gonna be all right. Rise up this morning, smile with the rising sun. Three little birds sit by my doorstep, singing sweet songs of melodies pure and true, saying, "This is my message to you." Ooh, ooh. Singing, "Don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing's gonna be
Hey, and don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing gonna be alright. Rise up this morning, smile with the rising sun. Three little birds beach by my doorstep, singing sweet songs of melodies pure and true, saying,
this is my message to you, woo-woo.
Meaning don't worry about a thing, worry about a thing, no.
Every little thing gonna be alright.
Don't worry.
Don't worry.
Three little birds sing.
About a thing. Every little thing gonna be alright.
I hope you guys enjoyed that video. Bob Marley's Three Little Birds. I love that song. So, hear that reggae in the background? Remember what I said about reggae. It's primarily in Jamaica. It's used for social commentary, for gossip, for probably all the things we use our music for. We got all kind of stuff in American music. So, that's it for today. One more video. Of course, you have to remember to wash your hands. And I will see you next Wednesday. So until then, have a great week. I love you guys, and I hope I get a chance to see you soon. Bye-bye.
Do I need you to wash your hands? Thank you.